In games, we very commonly have code where we need to wait for something to finish, such as an animation or a long calculation, before running some more code. In this example, I have a slime, and I'm going to attack the slime, and then I want to change the button after the slime played its animation. So look at this, I click the button, the animation plays, and then the button changes state. Here's the setup. I have a button in my scene, and the pressed signal of the button is connected to my root node here, to a function named onButtonPressed. This function first plays the heard animation of the slime, then we reach a line that says await slime.animationFinished, and then we change the button. This await keyword allows you to pause the state of the function until the signal on the right has been emitted. You can almost think of this as a signal connection, but there is an important difference. It's that when your code runs and the compiler reaches await, it's going to pause the function's execution on that line and wait for the signal on the right to be emitted. So the function is going to linger in memory. So you want to make sure that it does receive the signal at some point. And then the await keyword, unlike signal connections, allows you to keep asynchronous code or code that is spread over time pretty linear and easy to read. Here's one of the examples where await is very useful, a turn-based combat system. So in this example, we simulate the combat in a classical RPG with each of the enemies, AIs, taking action, and you have to wait for all of them to finish, to play animations and whatnot, before the player can regain control. Let's look at how we use await to make this work. So first, we have a node named characters, and each of its children is one of the actors participating in the combat. Now, if I head to the script that handles the turn-based combat, we have an infinite while loop, and the idea is that your combat system is an infinite loop of turns that ends, that you break out of, once all of the enemies or all of the players are down. And to do that, you can use the break keyword. In this simulation, we don't do that because we just simulate things and play animations. So for each turn, we loop over every character in the character node's children. And then we call a function called playNextTurn and pass the character playing the turn and use the await keyword to wait for this function to end. And at the end of each turn, we just wait for a short timer that creates a delay before the next turn. If I expand the playNextTurn function, you will find some awaits in there. And it's very important for this await, calling the playNextTurn function, to work. So we wait for various animations and other functions to make the whole combat loop pretty linear, because you have all the possible general actions that a character can take and the animations they play written and grouped in one function that you can read from top to bottom. And this is part of the beauty of using the await keyword. Subscribe to get more videos like these, and be sure to join our Discord community. It's a great place to give and get help from fellow Godot users. You'll find a link in the description.